Hey, what's up, everybody? Jim Flanagan here. It's the Draft Analysis Show, season number 3. The draft just went down, guys. We're about to kick things off for season 3. I got two partners here co-hosting the show with me tonight. As always, please welcome the man with the predictions. And he's got one posted already on the website. You guys, hop on to 239hockey.net. He's got an in-depth analysis posted on there. We're going to discuss that here on the show. Daly, welcome to the show, man.
Thanks, Flanny. As always, happy to be here. I do apologize. I know usually I'm a little bit better about getting those out. I've been a busy couple days. But as you can see, there is a lot of content there. So when it does go out, it is a wonderful thing. So I look forward to discussing all of this.
And we got a new member joining us here tonight on the show. It's not Giant918, but he's filling in here. I'm talking about D-Man, the locker room analyst there. He's got some analysis here on some of these players that Daly, both me and you may not know. And he'll bring it on the show. I'm talking about Mr. Dominator Silva. Welcome to the show, brother.
Hey, thanks for having me. Good to be here.
Nice. So let's get right into it, guys. We don't got much time. I know a lot of people playing their scrimmage games tonight, you know, because the season starts off next week. Schedule's up and posted on the website. You guys can check that out. Great job in whoever updated that schedule, everything running going. So let's get into it. I mean, we got 10 teams, 10 captains, went into the draft. We'll take a look how these guys drafted, what we think drafted our preseason. Season rankings here of each team's. I'll start things off here from first team. Captain by ACDC. First time captain here in the league. He did a lot of captaining last season, filling in there for Sabby. So he knows his role. I know he's been captain in other leagues before as well as a captain. His team there, the Afternoon Delights on there. First overall pick on his team was Chubbs Reborn. Himself, ACDC. He's got Dynasty, Gunny, Marine Mike, Slicky, and Lemieux between the pipes, man. Start off, Daly. What do you think about ACDC coming in this draft? His picks, his pick on the draft, like I said, was Chubbs Reborn. I don't think it was much of a question here. He was, I believe, the number 3 or 4 was it in the draft, man?
Yeah, he was the number 3 pick. I mean, here's the thing. I think it was common consensus across the board as far as like the top 4 or 5 picks, who they were going to be. It really just depended on the captain and what that captain was looking for. Chubbs at 3, you can't go wrong. He's a great starting piece. He's a good cycle player. He plays a two-way game. You know, those two-way centermen are really valued in this league because of what they bring, you know, offensively and defensively. I think AC had a pretty good draft. I really do. You know, defensively, I said that on draft day, I think Dynasty was a reach at 18, and I was like really blown away by that. But when I went back and looked at players available when I was doing this, I realized that, you know, there wasn't much left. AC could have went a couple different routes. Johnny Blaze slipped through the cracks. He went really late. There's guys I think he could have taken here, so I don't hate the pick, but Dynasty played most of last year, and that, if he comes out and gets, you know, the rust off, he could be an elite lefty, you know, and him and Gunny could be a nice pair. He also made a trade, picked up Marine Mike. You know, Marine Mike had a really good finals, you know, for the Hollywood Blondes last season, so that's big. And again, I think his best value pick of the draft was Lemieux in round 3. Lemieux had a great season last year for the Thundercats, got the cup. Him going at 23, I think people took my goalie reference a little bit too literal as far as last year. I said you can't take him early, but if you would have told me that Lemieux was going to go at 23 in round 3, I would have told you were crazy. But that was probably his best pick, obviously Chubbs, but the team should be good.
Billy, I believe that was the first goalie to go off the board too, right?
I believe it was. Lemieux might have been. I not 100% sure, but yeah, I believe he was, and he was the best goalie in the draft. You'll look at it. I think there's going to be 6 rookie goaltenders this year. It's crazy. I was doing it. I'm just like, geez, Louise, man. But yeah, so again, I think AC did pretty well with this draft. And again, you can read the full predictions that I have on there, but I definitely think that they're a playoff team, and given the, having Chubbs, a veteran presence like that, a guy who's been to the finals now, I think this team is pegged for a 5 or a 6 seed, possibly even a 4, if Dynasty can come back and play like, an elite lefty.
Okay. What about you, Dom, man? ACDC draft here, man. What do you think of the selection here for this team?
I would have to agree with most of what Daly's saying, simply because their goalie is the stud here. Obviously, I won a championship with him. He's really good. He can steal you games. If he has a really good D tandem in front of him, he can, again, save most, if not all, shots. So they really got to build from the net out with this team. And again, I'd kind of go with Daly and how these D are. I think that's the breaking point. Because Chubbs is very good, and I think AC is pretty fluid with whoever he plays. So, really, scoring might be the issue with this team. I could see that with Mike, AC, and Chubbs. So, if they have Kem, then, forget everything I just said. But, for the most part, they have the goalie to do it. He's proven he can do it. So, they just got to build around that.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you got Chubbs reborn, man, at the center spot there. Put guys around, like AC, where we might play with him last season, so a big chemistry there. Dynasty did go pretty early on there. I think that was almost like how Gunny went last season, and this season Gunny went pretty late in there in the draft. So I think it worked out there. How will that defensive side? I think I had my question on here with Dynasty and Gunny. Are we gonna see the Gunny of the season 1 Halifax Harpoons, so we're going to see the Gunny of last season. One of these D-men, I think, has got to step up. This is the time, I think, for Dynasty to really get his name out there. Like you mentioned, last season, playing in that most of the time, so we didn't see him on defense. We are going to see him here season 3, and I think that's where it comes down to on this team, how solid that offensive pair plays as well. They got a solid goaltender in there to back him up, but he can't save them all. So.
Yeah, that's when you're looking at it, that's basically the biggest thing. So, I have this team pegged for the playoffs. It's going to be, questions on offense. Is Marine Mike going to play like he did in the finals? And, I think that Dynasty was a little bit overdrafted. I think Gunny was underdrafted. I think I made that pretty well known. I said last year that Gunny was a really nice number 2. See how it goes, but how it goes. Very balanced. I think AC had himself a very safe draft other than taking Dynasty, what I thought was a little early, but he made up for it by getting Lemieux to kind of back that up, and I think Lemieux went late. So I think he made up for it.
All right. Let's move on here. Next team on here, the Blazing Saddles, man. I can't wait to hear Daly's picture on there. Captained by Magutukara, shut season from X. Daly, another season here. Magutukara, last season, made it to the playoffs, made it to the semifinals. Captaining the Blazing Saddles here. He went with a lot of questionable picks early on. A lot of these newcomers, I'm talking about Moose, I'm talking about Burks coming in there. He got Cody. Cody had 2 solid seasons so far. He's got C-Dub, 21, another year. A new goaltender in Tomahawk. Real veteran, I'm sorry, is McCall. Is that going to affect anything here on these picks? Daly, I don't know much about Daly. I don't know. I'm going to let you take over what you know, and you want Dominique Servant to chime in here as well. What about McGill's draft? Go ahead, man.
Yeah, here's the thing. McGill is notorious for doing this. He does his homework. He scouts. He does all these things to put himself in a situation to really usually compete. Now, last year, I thought McGill had a terrible draft, and I said that. But being the seasoned vet that he is, he made some trades, and that team got better, and they made it to the Final 4. So he obviously knows what he's doing. Here's the thing. he wasn't completely wrong with his draft. It's weird. It's so weird because here's the thing. Moose is a top three D in this league. He's a rookie this year. I guarantee you he's going to be a top three lefty. Now I'm talking No Cause, Megilla, Moose. Now, when you're Megilla and, you know, you would be drafted as one of the top lefty, why are you drafting a lefty with your first pick? I question that. Now, Megilla has made it clear that he's going to right D, which is fine. Now, Megilla's an elite lefty. Is he an elite righty? I don't know. I think he can be. You know, guys can make the swap. But I'm really starting to think, well, you never know the whole thing. So there was that. Then he takes Burks, who's also a very good forward as well. Again, I think these guys could have waited, but the way that Megilla's draft was, having all of his picks done by 31, you knew there was going to be some reach picks. There were guys that he took chances on, so on and so forth. I'm not surprised to see these guys go earlier than I thought they would. He got Cody as well. I know a lot of people in the league like Cody. Cody is definitely a solid number two, number three guy. He's played kind of that third forward role the last 2 years with the Hollywood Blondes, and he played with Chubbs and Steve. You know, again, I'm looking at it. He's got to take the next step this year because I don't think Burks is going to be able to get it done himself. He's got to take the next step. He's got to get into that next echelon of forward. I think he has the skills to do it. He's smart, but he's got to take that next step. Tomahawk and C-Dub, I don't know a lot about. I don't know if they're MHL guys. I think I mentioned that in there. But those are your wild cards. Can those guys be game changers? If they can, now you have something. But I think the D pair of Moose and Megilla is going to really set them over. Set them by kind of put them as far as playoff prediction. And that 4-6 seed, I really see them being more of like a 5-6 seed if you're asking me for the exact number. But again, it's going to be dependent on what, you know, if Cody takes that next step. And then if Tomahawk and Dub, are they game changers or are these guys duds? So yeah, that's kind of what I saw when I was breaking down that roster.
What about you, Dom, man? Any surprises here, man? Can you chime in here?
I mean, I'm shocked because, yet again, I have to agree with Daly, and you know how much I hate doing that, but, like, I got to start. Right? I got to start with calling out Cody. Now, in the most respectful of fashion and, you know, cards on the table, I only know Megs and Cody on this team, but I have played a full season with Cody. I know how that guy plays. So what I'm agreeing with Daly on is he does need to take the next step. He's played two seasons with Chubbs now. I think Chubbs, you drafted both of them last year, Ali?
Well, I drafted on Yam.
Yeah.
Prior season. Yeah.
And I was with him on Yam's team. He 100% is, it's hard to say, he's a compliment player. Now, that shouldn't be, you shouldn't take offense to that. But if you just have Cody, and again, because I don't know the other guys on this team, as your forward, if he's your predominant forward, and he's your go-to producer, you better have someone setting him up. That guy can finish, that guy can shoot, but as a, you know, a part of, like, him playing defensively with zone exits and zone enters, he's not the best at that. You want someone getting in there for him and setting him up. That's typically what I've seen. I don't know if he's come a long way, but he is being groomed, I think, to be a number one forward on a team. And this team, if it depends on their forwards and they need a hero, he needs to step up. And he can, because he's had two good seasons, two successful-ish seasons on two pretty good teams. So that's what I'm seeing from this team.
We'll see if Cody has it to carry a team, man. The goaltender in here, Tomahawk, actually surprised me a lot, man. I mean, this is one of the goalies that I freaking praise a lot on the show, man. I like what I've seen from him. So I think Megilla really has a solid goaltender. As last season when he had Shorty's 4 days, he came out of nowhere too. It's like he picked a guy, like, you know, ended up swapping when he got rid of Thug CTC. I really think this Tomahawk guy could be the next big thing in net as a top goaltender in this league. But a lot of these new guys, I don't know how the chemistry here. Megilla, you know, I don't know. I mean, he comes into these drafts, man, with these picks, but then he comes and he produces and he's in the playoffs. So, you know, veteran out there, hopefully he's got a knockdown here. We'll see what happens, man, with the Blazing Saddles. Anything else you guys want to add on here before we move on?
I think we covered it there. Yeah, I mean, like I said, they're a bubble team for me, but they have what seems to be the skill and the players to potentially make it in the playoffs there.
All right, so let's next on, man.
Next on, my favorite captain,
Cameron himself, Collins here. Shock, Chaos Rider, call what you want, man.
Build the wall. Build the wall. Just got 10 feet higher.
There we go, man. He drafted. Now, he drafted a couple guys he played with last season. I mean, I see Don on here. He picked
Stradios
with his first pick. No question there. He's got Hollywood Bob again. Shock himself. And then he's got the Rookie of the Year candidate, Crazy Yeti Killer, again, coming here second season around. Octizzy, a guy came back into the league here. What do you think here, Daly, man? I mean, Shock came in. Questionable. You know, he went with Drift with his first pick. What about his draft this season, man? Has he improved?
I don't know. It's tough to say. I'm saying no. He took Steve with the second overall pick. Steve would have been my first pick if I was captaining.
Same here, man.
You know, again,
same
we all played.
Here, same here.
We play different positions, so there's that. But if X Daly was captaining this year, he would have taken Steve with his first pick. With that said, I like that pick. After that, again, I just, you know, I literally preached how good and how improved he was at center, and then he didn't draft a goalie, and now he's been. I was having nightmares to season 8 of a league that I used to play with. Nightmares. They're a Chaos Rider, and all those things were born with him in net. But he is older, he is mature now. He tells me he can still play it. I have no reason to not take his word for it. You don't know, everybody knows I'm a big fan of him and the way that he plays. I think Bob took a step into being, you know, a better D-man last year, but I look at the positions and then I look at some of the other teams and I just don't see it. You know, I see them struggling with other teams. There's a lot of holes on this team. So I have him finishing, you know, 7th and 9th. As the lineup sits, I think the sensible move is to try and trade for a goalie, move down to right D, Cameron moves up to center, and now all of a sudden you have a little bit different look, a little bit different feel, and I like the lineup just a lot more. So that would be my suggestion to him, but we'll see. Chemistry is a big thing, but I don't know. What do you guys think?
Well, I'm kind of happy I finally disagree with you on something. 100%, I like this forward lineup. Now, that's not to say there's, like, far and away, you know, an all-star here with Steve, Yeti, and Dunn. I played with Dunn and Yeti. They're both pretty solid. I think Dunn plays a pretty good two-way game, and Yeti could finish. Steve is obviously an amazing, like, playmaker. Again, I had a season with him as well. Not in love with him at that, so I don't feel like it's going to be crazy. But, again, I do agree with that. Chemistry would depend on it. I played with Oktai. Shout out to Octazy, back in the day, and he is pretty decent on D. Like, he's not the worst, but I don't think he's going to steal any games for you. And Shock, just to provide some backstory, he recently won a championship on a very good team a couple seasons ago in another league. So I don't hate that at all. I'm surprised he actually went back to goalie, but from prior experience, this guy can. Yeah, he could steal you a game, and he could steal you a series. So, I don't know, man. I could see these guys in playoffs. I think they're a dark horse, in fact.
Okay. I mean, I've heard a lot of good things about this Dunn guy, man. I've played games with him as well. But then I got a lot of these other guys telling me, no, Hollywood, I don't know. I think you're looking at him too much, man. But I like the way Dunn plays. I mean, I like his style. He's a great passer, man. I mean, he's the open guy. I think if Stradio is going to have a great season with a guy like Dunn at center, we'll see if Yeti could produce here this season. Didn't do much last season, but he's got a much better lineup with this squad. Hollywood Bob definitely stepped his game up. I mean, he did great until that playoff series. Bob had a tremendous season, though. Octizzy is a big question mark to me, man. I mean, can the old man still produce? And I don't know. I haven't seen Octizzy in a long time. Some people said he does. Some people said he doesn't have the same type of game that he had back then. You know, here he is, 239 hockey, Almagrol, Octis, he's a Turkish Terminator. I think that brings up the big question mark. I mean, he's another guy that could play multiple positions, but with Shock, I don't know. I mean, I'm excited to see this lineups. I thought Shock did tremendous Shock up front last season. He's going to be playing in that this time around, and we'll see if that offense clicks, man. I mean, I love Stravinsky as well, man. I would have picked him with my first pick, you know, as well. I wish I did last season. I think we would have won the cup. But, you know, big upstairs, Fear the Wolf, Shock. Anything else on this team, guys? Octizzi. I think Octizzi is playing in the 239 as full time here, man.
Yeah.
Oh, is he? Because I thought he said that he still planned on playing two leagues in his sign-up. I could be wrong. That's where I pulled that information from, but...
I recently checked the other league, and I don't see his name, but I also thought the same thing. I guess he just committed fully, maybe recently.
Okay. Well, yeah, no, that works out then, and, you know, like I said, that's great. They're getting a full-time player, so that kind of takes out that portion. I wrote that. And we'll talk about that with some of these other teams a little bit more so, but good. That's great. You know, you're getting a full-time player, and you're getting a great guy. Octizzi's great to have in the party, so, shout out to Octizzi, man. He's great.
Hilarious. Love that laugh, Oct.
The giggles, man. That's all you need, man. We gotta get him on the show, man. Just have him giggle. That's it, man. Be worth the mission. Moving on here, new kid on here, man. Second season round on here. How well does he know the league? We'll find out, man. His draft came in. Couple picks here. A lot of guys were questioning, including myself. Let's take a look down here. It's Gun Ascended. It's the team name here. I'm talking about Agent. Picking off Cosmic Fade with his Cosmic pick. No Cause Renegade. Swagger.
Boo.
Agent himself. New goaltender here. I don't know how you pronounce this guy's name.
Mito Garden? I think it's Mito Garden. I've heard it. Played with him.
He's AKA the Dragon. You got DJ. I Soldier Up on here. And Dunker Fudd, man. First time captain here, Dally here. What do you think about Agent's draft?
You know, he traped the shit out of Legion, so that happened. Here's the thing. I think he got the first round right. No Cause at 6 was great. I like Fade. I think Fade took a step last year. A step that I think Cody needs to take this year, which we talked about. I think Fade took that last year from an offensive standpoint. So I like the pick. You know, the first 2 weeks, first four series are a big question mark. Who's going to play right D? When I was looking at the roster, the only thing that made sense was put Swagger at center. For that. Now, with that being said, the offensive talent is here. But two of your forwards have this issue. They're not great defensively. They want to shoot the zone. They want to get the puck with space. And I'm talking about Swagger and Fade. I think that can be a problem when you have two guys like that who really like to play with the puck, but there's only one puck. Okay, that poses an issue. I think playing without the puck is a very underappreciated thing in these games, knowing where to go when you don't have it, knowing where to go when somebody does something, and always understanding the play. I think Swagger and Fade really lack in that department. I think they're great finishers, but I think they lack in maybe some of the IQ aspects. And it's not a shot that I'm not calling them dumb. I just think that they're better with the puck without. But now you have two players who need the puck, and it's just not going to happen because there's obviously only one. So again, there's some question marks on this team. I think they have a great chance to be good offensively. The defense is going to be solid. DJ was a stretch where they took him, especially to play his off side, because No Cause is locked down left. You don't take the number 6 overall and play him on the right. I think he refuses it anyway. So DJ got the goalie. they got the C-plus rating for me because I know that DJ has and is willing to play net, so that helps as well. Maybe, you know, if it doesn't work out, you move middle garden out to D or something. I don't know, but it gives you some flexibility. As a team, in a nutshell, though, I don't necessarily think that they're a playoff team. What's the chemistry going to be like? The first 2 weeks could sink them. It could literally sink their season, because if they don't get off, you know, if they lose those series, they could be done. So I have them pegged 7-9, probably closer to 9. I think it's going to be problematic. A lot of run and gun. There's not going to be a lot of time on the tack. I think it's just going to be very chaotic at times. But there's skill there. So it's weird to say, what will the chemistry be like? But I have them missing the playoffs. What do you guys think?
I don't know. I think I have to somewhat differ again, simply because Smegger is skilled. Again, this is me expecting him to have a full team game. And I like Faye, too, so I feel like they could get shit done. Agent up front, I think, would be nice. I've only played with him recently a couple times. That may be a cluster shoot, so I'm not sure they're going to have any breakouts. But if they do, if everything gels well, I love their back end. Mito is actually a beast. He might, I think, steal some goalie awards or stats this season. He's really good. And I love No Cause on D. And either DJ or Agent on right D would work as well. So I love their back end. Again, so I kind of agree with it. It's just, again, chemistry up front. And with that being said, all these teams are starting to look alike. I feel like they could make it. They could bubble it. But it really depends on Swagger, I think. If he gels well, he'll push that team to elite status. If not, then they're just another, you know, scrap heap.
Yeah, I mean, Agent here, I mean, I love the goaltender. Here's another goaltender I like, man. New goaltender here. This guy, Dragon, I think he's going to shock a lot of guys here this season, man. Coming in with a name like that, maybe guys didn't want to pick him. But I thought he was a solid pickup in net. No cause run again, no doubt, man. I mean, shut down defensive guy. And I like where you went with DJ, because DJ could be that defender that could move up, could take the extra shots up front. But he does miss him the first 2 weeks. As long as they don't go down too far, man, get a couple wins in those first 2 weeks. You know, don't end up like the freaking Yeti Bombs. I think they'll be all right, man. I think this team can make the playoff run on there. Cosmic Fade, I love the pick. I don't think he took him too early. I think Cosmic Fade has proven himself last two seasons. But, you know, he had Marty McFly those two seasons. And, you know, with this, can Agent do that? Can a guy like Swagger coexist here, man? It's gonna be interesting to see, man. First time captain here, Agent 2 himself. You know, a lot of guys, I know Bash the guy as well, Bash on his game, just his game alone. So we'll see what happens. I mean, you know, Agent played with the Hippie Crew most of last season, so we didn't see much of that. He didn't get much ice time this time as captain. I'm pretty sure we're gonna see him, if not in all the games here. So I think he's definitely got to step his game up here, and we'll see what Swagger can do here without a guy like Chubbs Reborn. I'm sure No Cause Renegade loves No Cause Renegade.
We'll find out.
Was there also some friction with him? I didn't know that.
I think, isn't he in London right now? It'll be fun when he gets back to see the reaction for that. So.
Oh, that'd be great.
I thought season 2 was over. Speaking about coming back, how about D-Mart, man? A lot of almost a lot of people's favorite coming into this draft. D-Mart, third time captain. I mean, he's won the cups twice, both times as captain. Here he comes again, man. Season 3, the Halifax Harpoons, man. That team name. Just got cups all around, man. How well did he draft here? Let's take a look here. Going with Marty McFly, his first pick. Newcomer, Dank, man. Heard a lot of good stuff about this guy. You got D-Mart himself. Johnny Blaze, man. Got him pretty late in this draft, man. Same thing with, hi, my name is Ed. He came off the boards pretty late. And goaltender in X-Ability. Daly, you're real good friends there with D-Mart. you know, besides him being such a good friend? What do you think about his draft, man? Let's put that all aside, man.
Again, the offense will be elite. Anytime Dan's out, you know, out there, it's going to be a good offensive set. He gets to play with his brother. That's instant chemistry. I was super impressed with that Danklove. I played a couple games with him. He moves the puck. He's quick. He wasn't trying to do too much. He has the ability to finish, but he's smart, and I think that's something that a lot of times new forwards in a league, they try too hard, and you just you try too hard to make yourself look bad. I think he did everything right in the scouting games, and one of the better forwards in the league recognized him, and now he gets to play with him. So I think they're going to have a really good season up front. Ed, last year I shit on him where he got taken. That's obviously no fault of his. I loved the value here where he got him. I think it was pick 44 or whatever it was. And yeah, man, it was crazy. DJ, I think last year was a... He did, yeah, and he's full-time. So I think last year the numbers weren't great, but, you know, that he was on some struggling teams, so that's no fault of Ed. But I love where he got taken this year. And Johnny Blaze himself, man, DeMar must have saw what I saw, but we played them the last series before the playoffs last year, and Johnny Blaze was literally the most noticeable person on the ice. And I'm talking about King Rome, Big Head Steve. Those guys were playing in that series. And Johnny freaking Blaze, man, was literally the most noticeable player on the ice. He was playing such good hockey. I'm shocked he fell. I know Legion was looking at getting him, but I was absolutely shocked that he fell. And, you know, again, I think Dan did really well in the back end of his draft. Goalie's going to be a question mark. Is Billy going to be the guy, another rookie goaltender? But I know Dan, and Dan does his homework. And, again, I think the team will be top three, top four team. Daniel Martin has never missed the playoffs, I don't think ever. So, yeah, you have no reason to expect that these guys aren't going to make it. What do you think?
You know more than me about the Martin brothers. I've played with McFly. I think I've seen DeMar once or twice, like on your team. Obviously, he's very skilled. I'm not worried about their offense at all. I played with Ed and Blaze before. Shout out to Blaze, by the way. Grind. But Ed is. I don't know. I'm not excited about him on D. Great guy in a party. But I want to see how he gels with Blaze. But they could again if they're hitting hard and have a good defensive positioning, they could run away with it. Regardless of who their goalie is, which is good because I don't know who he is. That's pretty much it.
Dilly, what do you think? DeMar would do something like put Morty on lefty and bring Johnny Blaze at center, man.
No, I don't even think it's an option. I don't think it's an option. I think that, you know, he drafted Marty. I said I like Marty back there. It's an option. It's something you can definitely do. I think that the Martin brothers are going to do their best, Henrik and Daniel, this season. I think you're going to see that all year. If shit goes south, I think Dan will try and make trades other ways. But, yeah, no, I think you're going to see that all year. But it is an option, and Johnny Blaze does give you that a little flexibility if someone misses a series or this or that. But, again, they've got some nice depth, and I think Dan had a good draft. Top four, in my opinion. He'll be there.
Trades, man. Hmm. Would he give up blood?
I don't know about that.
Well, one thing's for sure, I don't know about that. The Halifax Harpoons win the championships. Both of the Marty brothers here take the cup. So, you know. Let's move on, man. Let's move on here. What about this guy? Another new captain, man. Pale Poner. Solid season playing alongside with McGilla. And shot first, man.
Shot first.
Is that misspelled or what, man?
No, Han shot first, like Han Solo.
German?
I might have spelled it wrong, but yeah, no, I think that's what it was.
Okay, all right. So let's take a look here, man. Yeah, Beastly Jesus, Brick City, Brick Tail Poner himself. Was this first pick? I believe it was Derek GNR, man. He was up there pretty early.
It was, yeah. That was his first pick.
That's a good pick.
My opinion. You got Stoey Joe, aka Joe Stowe, Rico, and Fat Lord. all right, let's take a look here, man. Basically, Jesus, I've heard some good things about the guy here. He got Joe Stowe pretty late, man. I don't even know what number he came off the board, but I saw his name on that draft board for quite a while. Derek Gina and R, no doubt. I mean, you know, one of the, if not the top defenders in the league. What do you think here, Daly?
Well, I'm looking at it. Derek was his first pick, and here's the thing. I did this. I made mention of it. Derek, if he's full-time committed to this league, would be a top five pick in the discussion. But he, you know, again, in these signups, he's making it very clear that this isn't your primary, and this isn't a shot at all. It's not. So don't take it that way. But if I'm a captain, and I see in your sign-up that you're telling me that my team, our team, would not be your first priority, then you're automatically off my draft list. I don't care how good you are. Because I'm here at 239 to do the bid. I'm here at 239 to focus on here. I'm not against playing in other leagues. But I'm not going to deal with the, I don't care how good you are. I have this league that night. Me personally, as soon as I see that, they're off my draft list, and it's not a shot. It's just what it is. Now, if Derek was playing here full time, boom, all over it. Top five pick. Pale got himself a good player, but here's the problem. He went out and got Beastly Jesus, who's also a Beastly player, but is also in two leagues. So now I worry about Pale Poner trying to balance two leagues. I look at the back end, Rico and Fatlard, and that seems to be a battle right now. From my inside sources tell me that he doesn't actually know who's going to play net, so it's kind of a toss-up right now. But again, the offense, question mark, if these guys show up, the lineup's good. With Derek and Beasley and Stoey Jopa and Brick City, who, from what I remember, is really, really solid, and Derek and Pale would be a top D-man himself. Goalie is going to be the question mark regardless this year. If that lineup shows up, I think they're in the top six, but I question the confliction between the two leagues. So that's my take on it. And again, it's not to shoot on anybody, but it's a lot of work. I mean, managing part-time players and guys in other leagues, it makes it very, very, very difficult. So I'll leave it at that. What do you guys think?
I'd happen to agree. I mean, let's be honest, cards on the table. I am one of those players. I'm a guy in another league. I'm a guy that has that league prioritized. So just to give you some parity with that, like, yes, there's one side of it. You should, most likely as a captain or, you know, running a draft for a captain, take guys like that have a league priority over your league out. And likely the other half of that understands that. So 100%, if you're coming into a league and, you know, you have one that's priority over another, I mean, it's no surprise that your draft stock would fall, or, you know, there could be some scheduling issues. With that being said, the guys that he has that does that, I would argue maybe are almost worth it. Simply because he has Derek, Stoey, and Beasley. And I know these guys from the other league, and they're fucking studs. They're great. So you are right in the fact that if they're all there, this is a good lineup. I think it's a stud team. And with the other leagues that I know they're in that have moved to fewer series a week, I don't think it'll be that much of a risk seasons would dictate. But to focus on the team specifically here, Brick City, I've heard good things about, but I don't know how good he is. Stoey's one of those, you know, realistic forwards, complimenting offense he's on. And Beastly Jesus, I mean, Daly used this about me a couple seasons ago. This guy can play every position, and he can play it well. If I were to ever name a successor to the utility guy throne that I claim, it would be Beastly Jesus. He is fucking phenomenal. He's great at every position. And I don't know if he signed up for everyone for this league, but if he did, that's great. But again, availability, who knows. Pale was pretty good on D when I played him last year, and I don't know about their goalie. That's the only suspect thing. But I really, really like this team, and if they ice their starters every game, cup contender, hands down.
Okay. Well, there's even some discussion that I think
Pale himself might be playing in that, man.
I mean, you look at the draft pool, you look at the positions on there, that might be a thing as well. You know, a lot of big names on here, too. I mean, Joe Stone himself, Beastly Jesus, Derek GNR. But, yeah, when availability becomes an issue, I mean, you know, when you got to go to the waivers and you know there's chin strap on there, man, come playoff time and stuff, that becomes a problem, man. And, you know, I think even Pell himself might be playing other
elsewhere as well. So, I mean, you know, when you try to juggle too many things at once, something's got to give here, man.
I agree 100%. So, again, it wasn't, you know, I wasn't trying to shoot on anybody or, you know, cause unnecessary fake news. But, man, you know, again, I just, for me, when I'm looking at it, it does. And you made a great point, Ollie. I mean, look at last year. It wasn't based on anybody's availability, but I unfortunately had a trip and, you know, it came down to having to use, you know, waivers in a playoff series, and you hate to see that. So, with all that being said, you know, again, availability is a big thing and it does matter. So, anybody who thinks it doesn't, I mean, take last year with Jello Time, for example. We'll leave it at that. But
and part-timers.
And I heard some things also about Fat Lord. I don't know if he's responding to Pill or something, if he's listening on the show. you know, and in the chat.
Respond to your captain. Yeah. Respond to your captain. Yeah.
Not that hard.
All right, let's move on, man. Let's move on here. Drift King coming in as captain. I know it's like pulling teeth getting this guy on here, but he is captaining season 3 Justice League on here. Let's take a look, man. Going with his picks, got.
Yeah, I mean, you look at the lineup. Esoteric superstar Drift, Kayla, BC Lefty. I mean, this is yeah, man. It's a good team.
Vancouver,
it's a good team. Yeah, you know, I wouldn't go that far. But if you look at it, Esoteric, man, I had him last year. He's a good buddy of mine. Great player, even better guy. Drift's first-round pick, and rightfully so. He's playing center this year. I used him at left wing last year. That's only because I had Chew Therapy, who, in my opinion, is one of the best centermen around. So Esoteric slid over because of his versatility, played left wing, and didn't even skip a beat. He's playing his actual position now, folks. Esoteric is a center by trade. So if you didn't know that before, you know that now. So Drift got his two-way center that he needs. Drift would be a first-round forward himself. He's playing right wing. I think Superstar is a nice complement to these guys. Kayla, she's freaking great. Awesome to have in parties. Again, not primary league. I won't go any further on it. Could be an issue. BC Ren impressed me a lot last year at the way that he played. He was on some bad teams last year. He showed up, and he was solid. He was noticeable. That's what I look for when I play these series, and that's where I get a lot of this stuff from. As I sit there and I say, you know, smart play here, little play here, I'm sitting there, I'm like, man, who the hell was that? Like, who was that guy? And then you take note, and BC Renton was a guy that I really noticed last year, and I got to play him twice because of trade, and he was noticeable. And then Lefty Gulford's back this year as well under a different gamer tag. I put Lefty on there because I was chatting, shooting the breeze with him the other night, and that's how I know him. So that was the name I put him under. But he's back. He looked great, too. This is a nice team top to bottom. Another issue, the only issue I would say is, again, two guys who like to have the puck. And those two guys are Drift King and Superstar. I've played with both of these guys. Esoteric is good without the puck. His goal total last year would say that a lot of those were getting in nice position and letting his teammates help him out. Drift likes to have the puck. Superstar likes to have the puck. This could be a problem. Again, there's only one puck out there. In my experiences, and this isn't a shot, but when I played on Midnight Express with Superstar, the one thing that I noticed is when he didn't have the puck, sometimes he would get lost in the offensive zone. So with that being said, with the puck, he's great. And I think that he's got to work on that part of his game. And if he does, that takes him into elite level, into that next level of being there. So, and then Drift, you know, just understanding what his team is, you know, when Kayla's not there, you know, Drift is going to have to fall back to D because I really am underwhelmed with Saint. And this isn't a shot at Saint or D Stopes. Those are forwards, man. Those guys are forwards. Those guys aren't D. Drift King can play the defensive spot. So the only thing that makes sense is dropping back. And the offense is good enough with Superstar and Esoteric that you can get away with having a D Stopes and Saint to really complement those. So that's my opinion. I do think they're a top three team. I think that that offensive line is really good. When Kayla's there with BC, they're going to be tough and lefty and net. So what do you guys think?
I would happen to agree with the assessment done online. I think this team is a top three team just on paper. I have played with most of these guys. I played with Drift, but usually he was a net. And, you know, Kayla and BC, obviously, I know them very well from the other league. They are probably equal or above average D. So together, they have some chemistry if needed back there. So I'm not worried about them. Lefty, again, if he's a goalie, that's great. So I'm not worried about their back end. Superstar, Drift, and Esso up top. They may lead the league and through the puck deeks or loose puck deeks at the fucking blue line. But at the same time, there's a lot of skill there. And hopefully they have chem. And again, my only critique with Superstar would be, you know, have better zone enters, you know, with your team and retain the puck, but he has really good hands and tight. He gets score a lot of goals. Esso's all around a good player. Just like you said, he plays really well without the puck as he does with it. So I can't see them dropping under top three. They just have all the tools. And I think the chem would be there because, you just need one or two smart players, up top, and, the rest is history.
I totally agree, man. I think, in my eyes, I think this might be the team to beat, man. I'm looking at Drift. I'm looking ahead at his picks, man. When the draft was happening, I mean, this guy did a phenomenal job. I think he picked the best person available at that time, man. Esoteric, man, off the board. Great, solid pick. He had Superstar, man. He got Drift himself. He still ended up with, like, when he took all those forwards at, right off the start, man, on the draft, he still ended up with Kayla, with BC, and Lefty in the net, man. So, like, I really don't see much weakness on this team. I mean, all these guys can play, and, you know, all these guys can score, man. They, you know, they've done it. They've put up points, put up numbers on there. Can they coexist here? We'll see, man. Season 3, I think that's the only thing that's left to see here, man. I mean, everything else, I really can't pinpoint a weakness on this team, man.
Yeah, again, they're there for me. That's why I pegged them top three. I can't disagree with you. But, yeah, only time will tell, but they're going to be up there. I can't see them missing the playoffs at all.
Let's move on. Next team, captained by X-Daily? X-Daily or is it Legion?
I think it's X-Daily. I think everyone knows
X-Daily.
Mighty Montards. What we got here, man? Let's see who we picked. We got X-Daily, number one, first overall pick in season 3 draft, man. Holy crap. Fire Customs, Camps, Donnywood, an odd guy, and then Mr. Legion himself.
Oh, my dear God. Let me just say this right off the bat. This will be the party to be in. You got Odd, you got Daily, you got Legion, you got Donnywood, who's fucking hilarious. You four in a party will destroy. I don't think you guys will ever concentrate on the game. You're just going to die laughing, or someone's going to hurt someone's feelings. I don't know.
Forget this podcast. We'll just put the live mic in that party, man.
Oh, my God. Please, fly on the wall.
That could be arranged. I think we could work that out. I'll have to talk to my captain. Man.
Make sure they put
Just keep Odd away from Legion. I sit in chat. Odd's a very nice, innocent guy. You can't have him near Legion. He's going to be corrupted within a second.
That's good. He's a sponge. He wants to learn.
Oh,
so
God.
That'll be good. Maybe putting him with Legion is, like, the best thing to do. I mean, I don't know. But with a team like the Mighty Mongo Tards, I already told Legion I'm not doing any write-ups this year because I refuse to use the material. Anyways, moving on to the actual team itself. Yeah, you know, Holly, you just kind of did it. I always feel weird assessing my own team, but I'll do it here, and I try and be as unbiased as possible. Thamps at 21 is a steal. Or I'm not 21, I think. Yeah, 21 is a steal. Sabby at 35 is a steal. I don't know how that happened at all. He wasn't on our list because I had him pegged for first, early second. Desire Customs is going to compliment them nice. If Donnie Wood was a full-time player, he'd be a top three, top four lefty in the league, in my personal opinion. He's also a top forward. And Odd Guy played a lot of lefty last year. He plays pretty much every position. He's a sponge. And he's going to get to play with some really, really good players this year. Obviously, the question mark is going to be Legion and Net. I can tell you right now with complete unbiased from what I've seen, Legion has made all the saves that he's supposed to make. And when you have good D, especially good team D in front of you, if you make the saves that you're supposed to make, it's going to go a long way. It's coming back from those soft goals that makes it really tough. Obviously, like I said, I'm playing D this year as well, which per usual. So, again, I think we have a really nice squad. I think we have a nice balance. I don't see us not making the playoffs. And, you know, this might be Legion's coming out party for future seasons, man. But I don't know. What do you guys think?
Yeah, he definitely has a lot to prove here, man. You know, we didn't see him much last season or even the season before then. Usually a filling guy there. Now he's got the starting role here, and he's filling in the goaltender position here. Yeah, so Legion, you know, with the draft here, man, I mean, you said he got robbed with agent, man, I think the draft, and, you know, just the position where he was in this draft, and to still draft a solid team, I thought was a phenomenal job, man. I mean, you look at it here, you mentioned Sabby. I mean, how late did he go, man? I mean,
you know, 35.
You know, is it because of last season where he didn't play much? His availability was an issue.
Maybe
people overlooked. You know, you got a new guy coming in here, Damps, but you know that name's been around, man. Desired Customs. This time he gets to play in the forward spot. He was stuck in that defensive side on the Yambag's team, and I'm really looking forward to seeing what Legion produces here. You said he's gonna make the stops that he needs to. Are you saying go far side on him or what, man?
No, I'm just, you know, like I said, from what I've seen thus far, you know, if he keeps making those saves, he's gonna be tough. You know, make those saves you're supposed to make and trust your D and, you know when who you got out there. That's a big thing. Sometimes you're on a bad team or something happens, or maybe your D-man isn't doing what you want him to do, so you start to take some chances. But, you know, the biggest thing for Legion is, hey, man, just understand and know who's out there. And I think if he does that and understand that he's got, you know, Donnie Wood and, you know, guys who've been playing D a long time, you don't have to do much, man. You don't need to do it all. You know, just do what you're supposed to, and it'll go a long way. So what do you think, Dom?
Yeah, Dom, I'm waiting to see what Dom's got to say. Are we going to see a season where X-Daily gets double digits put against them, man?
Is this the season? I think so. I think I'm going to cone Daly pretty hard this year. If I was a left winger, if he was a lefty, you know. But again, with that being said, you have to respect your opponent before you fucking wipe the floor with him. Daly and Donnie, that tandem, I think, is the tandem to beat, maybe next to Kayla and BC. Well, let's be real. You know, Donnie's a stud, he only ever compliments players that he plays with, and so the better the player that he plays with, the better he'll play, and actually the better that player will play. He's really good at doing that. So Donnie and Daly, I think, will be probably the best tandem in the league. Legion, I've never played with the guy. He is infamous across all the online leagues. So if I take Daly's word for it and how he'll play in net, and, like, you know, seriously, and, you know, doesn't fuck around half the time, I'm sure he'll do fine. Again, the forward line, Sabby's great. Sabby's a dangle dicker, Nintendo Power Glove. The guy just holds onto the puck all the time. I don't know how he does it. Thamps, I don't really know that much about. And DC, I think he had a pretty good season last year. I've heard a lot about him. I would agree with the prediction of them ending top four just on the back end alone, and you can maybe kind of throw up whoever you want. And sorry, yeah, and if Odd stepped in, that's not really a bad replacement either. But with that being said, I'm licking my chops to play these guys because, honestly, I want to cut through the best D. You got to play the best to be the best, so looking forward to it. I'm going to light Legion up, man.
Hopefully he listens to this show. You know how he thrives on that stuff, so.
Absolutely.
I beautiful. Have a slight question mark on the lefty spot, man. Again, X-Daily, you have part-time guys on the team. Donnie Wood's another guy that plays in, like, every other freaking league out there. We seen them last season part-time. They didn't really get much games, man. Is that availability going to stick again here in Season 3? If it is, here comes Mr. Odd Guy, man.
The thing is that, you know, I would, and the other aforementioned forwards, Dom Silva, Kayla, Derek GNR. Derek, Kayla, and Dom all signed up full-time. Donnie signed up part-time. So, and I don't know this for a fact because I didn't draft this team. Legion drafted this team. But I'm assuming when Legion drafted Donnywood, he said, okay, yeah, this guy plays another league. But if I tell this guy, hey, we have a series Tuesday and Thursday, which one can you play? The hope is that Donnywood can play one out of the, you know, one of those games. If he can't, you're an odd guy, you know, but, you know, it's going to be nice. I'll be able to play with odd this year. I think Dom made a great point in kind of feeding off the player you're playing with. You know, I know that, Odd is a forward first, but he showed last year he can play a bit of D, and I think maybe playing alongside me and me being able to help him out a bit, I think it could do some good for him. So, you know, we'll see. I think he can take it, you know, maybe his D game to the next level. Who knows? But I think our team will be okay. But yeah, no, that's pretty much it. I think we'll be top four, top five.
All right. Good analysis there, man. Always great to have X Daily announcing his own team, man. We got two more left, guys. Let's try to get this through here. We got Sober returning captains. Got to defend the title, man. Sober enough. What the hell is the team name? Motu?
I think it's Masters of the Universe. I think he's doing a He-Man theme this year.
Okay.
I think.
Okay, so we got, here we go. Stout Luca D was his first pick. He moved up in the draft. Obviously, and that's
hashtag Luca better than Lamp.
I'll leave that one alone. Hey, if it smells like cologne, leave it alone. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
I'll leave it alone.
Not true. Moving right along.
Snipers low. B Roos back in the league here. Hugh Laurie as a part time player, and you got Thug CTC. In that, what would you think about the mindset here of one sober enough?
Well, here's the thing, man. I'm if on this team, and here's why. You draft Luca, and I got this lineup from Sober, so this is a confirmed lineup. You know, I don't know if you guys noticed, I have confirmed and projected. This is a confirmed lineup. So Sober gave me this lineup. He drafts Luka number four. He plays Luka at right wing. It doesn't make sense to me. It just doesn't. So you got Hugh Laurie's playing part-time. When Hugh's not there, you're going to move Luka back to center, and then Snaper's going to come up, and that's great. But you use your number four pick on Luka, and you're going to have him switch positions all year. That doesn't make sense to me. You draft a guy round one, and that's your freaking guy. There's very few players that are like that. I would say a handful. Like, you're drafting Steve. Steve's playing right wing. Steve's not playing as willing. He's playing as preferred. You draft Chubbs. Chubbs is playing center. He's not playing right wing, right? You're playing him at their preferred. There's exceptions to the rule. I might fall into that category. You know, I prefer right D, but I can play forward too, but you might not be taking me at forward there. Point being is you took him at four, you play him at the position you took him at. Hugh Laurie's part-time, I understand that, but Hugh played all season last year right wing. I think at some point you're going to see Hugh slide over to right wing. Luke is going to go back to center because that makes the most sense. It's easier for Hugh to jump in one series a week, play that position, especially a position that he played literally for 27 games last year, whatever the case is. So the back end, if Roos is elite, this could really work. That'd be really, really nice to have him back there. Sniper actually showed me a lot. He's a bit more of an offensive D-man, which is nice. I love offensive D-man. It gives you a different look. Makes you think about something else. You know, again, I like to play the position that way too. You know, is this guy going to carry it? Is he going to chip it? Is he going to set a guy up? It adds a whole nother dynamic, and Sniper has a little bit in that. It's not refined, but he has it. So that could be really, really nice for this team. Just give him another outlet. Thug got a bad rap last year, man. He was drafted too early. I know we shit on him. Not him, just where he was. I think he's going to have a bounce back year this year. I think he was great value where he got taken. This team is going to be top five. I don't see how they won't. The big question mark, does Roos still got it? And is Luka going to play center all year? What do you guys think?
I mean, I kind of agree with the first round pick having, you know, he should play that position. He should play that position consistently, and he should be really good at that position. But at the same time, I've played with Luka before. He has very good forward skill, and I think that'll transfer well to being a center. And obviously, when I played with him, he was a center, and he did pretty well. So I think the only thing that could be harmful would be draws, maybe. But at the same time, how can you start Luke over Hugh? So I understand what Sober's doing here, and I think maybe he sees some, you know, universal type player in Luka, which is totally understandable. Again, maybe not as ideal, but I don't think it'll be that big of an issue for his team. And I've played with Sniper and Zilo before. These guys are good. I don't know how good they are on D. That's what I'm worried about. I love their goalie, Doug. He's great. So they're back in. Again, it may be a bit iffy for me, but not the worst. Yeah, I could see these guys finishing top five as well. I think they have a good template, good chassis, some good bones. Maybe they can run away with it here. And obviously, Sober's a defending champ, so I'm not worried about that or that forward line at all. They could be probably one of the most producing forward lines coming up in this season. What do you think, Aldi?
You know what, guys? I don't like this team at all, man.
Nightmares? Nightmares from the finals?
I don't want to see early fire sale on this team.
here's why, man. You mentioned a good point about the position-wise, the Luka on right wing. Hugh Laurie still has to prove himself here in this league, man. And, you know, when you have part-time guys, you know, it's one thing to have on the wings or on defense, but when you're moving around the center position, I think that's a key fact in the forward spot. You know, you got Hugh Laurie still needs to prove himself in this league that he still got it. Then nice when he's not there. Now you're rotating. So now what? You're bringing Stealth Luka back to the center spot, and you're gonna bring another guy to the wing. And I don't like that at all. Birus, I mean, he's been out for quite some time. Again, like I questioned Octizzi, I'm questioning Birus here as well, man. I think Doug CTC might have another nightmare season here, man. I'm calling it right now. You know?
Yeah, I mean, again, there are some question marks. There are. It's hard for me to assume that a guy forgot how to play. And that's where I'm at with Roos. I think Roos has still got it. There was a time when he was considered a top D.
There's a guy, Deli, also that he wanted, I think, to play the wing spot.
Here's the thing, Holly, and we've talked about this.
I don't think his defensive spot is one of his primary positions as it used to.
Well, he put it as willing, so you have to understand something. You know, when you have a name and you are somebody that, you know, people remember, you have to understand, like, hey, you put willing, you're a D-man. People know you as a D-man. You shouldn't have put willing, you know, if that were going to be... if that's what you wanted to play. Here's the thing. I kind of got on Superstar about it, but he did it right, man. Hey, I want to play left wing. I want to play lefty. If you want to draft me at these positions because this is where I play. So if Roos really wanted to play right wing, he should have put right wing and said, this is where I want to play, and refused everything else. But with that being said, I don't think you just forget how to play the position. I just don't think that it works that way. I think he'll be fine, and I like how this team looks. So we'll see how it goes.
Yeah. I don't think it's going to be another one of those sober seasons, man. that's for sure, man. But,
I agree. I don't think it will be, but I also won't be surprised if it is.
You know, and then I don't know. I mean, I'm looking at the team besides Birus. You got Sizey Prince as well, which mainly I see these guys on the forward spot, man. You guys going to play D here. We'll see, man. Maybe it surprised me, man. Maybe I'm looking too much into it, man. That leaves us the team here, Mr. Yan back. Wasn't gonna be captain. Came back as captain here. He's captain every freaking season in this league and other leagues. What the hell we got here? Wander Chosen. Team name.
Mm-hmm. The Wander Chosen, you know, Yam can never just have a normal flipping name, right? So, Wander Chosen. Yeah. Anyways, sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you. That was my fault. But you got BCO, Edge, John Monkey, Dominator Silva, Valcor, Ballbag, and Holly. Fuck, you guys are on the same team. I forgot about that. Anyways, let's talk about your team. I'll tell you what, man. I think that Yambag really killed his draft. And it's weird because, you know, it's very easy to want to shit on Yam. I think he had a terrible draft last year, and they made the playoffs, but I think they went like 0-14 to end the season, but they had a really good start. They beat the teams they were supposed to. That's great, but he did it right this year, man. BCO, he's one of those guys I want to see take the jump. He's gone first round the last 2 years. I want to see him take that next step. Edge and John Monkey are a really nice combo. Dom with full time, and if he were playing here as his primary, I think Dom's a first round pick. But because, you know, there's always that question mark, you can't take him in the first. But he's taken the next step from being that Swiss Army knife to, hey, listen, you know, I'm a legit forward now. I'm a legit guy here. This is what I play. Valcor was great for me last year. Now he's full time. Getting him in, I think, round 3 or 4. That's stupid. Shouldn't have happened that way. And I know Yam had dreams of playing left wing this year, but his best position's right D. And he knows that, and the league knows that. Holly and Nett, top 3 goalie in the league. I think Yam really killed this draft. I think you guys are top 5. The only question mark I have, your team is balanced. I can't say that enough. Like, I don't think that necessarily that the best players are on this team, but I think you have the best. Good. I don't think you're weak at any one position. I think you have a player at every position, even to your 6th guy, who John Monkey, who I played with one season, but I remember certain things, and I remember being impressed with the way that he played the game. So I know it's weird to talk about your team, but I think, honestly, and I said it underneath, I think Yambag had the best draft all around. So what do you guys think about your team?
Wow.
Yeah. Wow. I feel my tires are pretty pumped.
Hopefully Yambag's listening, man. And Yambag always gets that freaking, what do you have, like the 9th pick in the draft?
Yeah, he was 9. He was 9.
Yeah. Like 9 and 12?
Yeah, 9 and 12.
But just to go off of that, like, I agree with obviously most of that, and to try and be as unbiased as possible, I like to be pretty analytical with every player on your team, on any team. I'm kind of just going to be straight up honest, and obviously not trying to offend anyone, because, you know, it's, at the end of the day, it's a game, and skill is skill, and people are better than other people. So again, with that being said, I think probably our weakest spot on D is our captain, and that's what you want your team to be, because what's the captain supposed to do? Draft people worse than him? And with that being said, playing with Yam, again, this is going to be my 2nd season under his regime. I think he's made strides. We're definitely working on things. I think if there is a quote unquote weak spot, it's closing pretty quickly. So with that being said, I agree with you that I think this team is pretty balanced. I was unfamiliar with Valcor in the past. He's a stud lefty too. To me, I'm sorry, I don't want to make that distinction, but he's up there with, like, No Cause. He's up there with Kayla. He's up there with, you know, the top 5, top 3 D in the league, lefty in the league, to be fair. Holly, it's unfortunate we have a 7 net, but what can you do? And you got me, Biko, and Edge up top. Again, I've been in every year in the leagues for since 2015 with Biko, and I've never played with Biko before. And for those wondering, apparently that's how you pronounce his name. It's not BCO. That guy, and Daly, you touched on it in your analysis. Will he make strides to be an elite center? I think he has, but maybe that's just the chemistry that we have, because he's really good. He kills it on draws, great two-way, great vision in the offensive zone, hits me with passes. I mean, if we're anywhere near the top of the standings in both stats and actual team standings, our names will be next to each other, and it'll mostly be Biko doing the work. And you know what? I also agree with Edge and John. They're, to me, and I don't want them to take this as an insult, they're interchangeable. Their skill is pretty equal, and they mesh well. I think the only thing that could matter is who we play with more, which will most likely be Edge, who's full-time, and John, who's part-time, and again, in another league. So that's good that we have some duality like that. So I commend Yam on that drafting. Your confirmed lineup is correct. It will be mostly Edge, Biko, and me. We have played some practice games. We do have chemistry, and I think we're going to do well.
Absolutely, man. Absolutely. Yambag had a phenomenal draft, man. Where he was placed on the draft, number 9 pick, after all the guys got picked, Afradios, Jobs, you know, on and on, I think he went with the next best thing and a very underrated player in Brian Collins, man. Solid center, man. I played with this guy in the beta season, and We could have easily won that cup in that beta season, and the reason why Brian Collins wasn't there night number 2, I don't care what X Daily says or thinks,
Brian Collins wasn't there in 9-9 too. Otherwise, I think Yamba otherwise could have easily won the cup that season and took him down DeMar. And I think Yamback noticed that, and he went with what worked, man. It got us to the championship. And that's what he's looking for here this season. Brian Collins at that pick was a solid pick. You know, you got Dominator Silva. Where he picked Valco was just insane. Now Yamback's playing down Yamback's spot, which he didn't play last season. I don't know why, but it just didn't work out with the guys he drafted. But now he's going to be at the right thing. And you got Mr. Hollywood in that Hollywood Daily. Daily, I got a lot to prove for you. I got this season more than any other seasons. Just the way this draft went, man. All these goalies went off the board, man. And there was Mr. Hollywood. You know who picked him up? Mr. Yamback. Yamback picked him up, and I'm not letting him down this season. Season number 3. Daily, I'm going for the cup run, man.
All right, cool. That's what I like to hear. I mean, you know, there's a lot of good parity. There's a lot of balanced teams. I don't see a runaway. You know, I see 5 or 6 really solid fucking teams. So I'm excited for this year. There's more parity, I can tell you right now, than last. You know, last season I felt like there was just 4 teams. You know, last year there were 4 teams that you really stood out to me in my draft analysis, and this year there's 6, 7, 8, you know, that are really right there. You know, so I'm excited, man. Like, I really am. I think this is going to be a fun year, and I think it's going to be a balanced year. And I look forward to getting it started. And it starts next week, man. It comes up so fast. It comes up so fast. So
it's crazy, man. It's crazy. But yeah, man. I'm gonna post this audio recording probably up there with your post, Daily, so people could listen to it.
Okay.
And read your prediction line there. Hopefully get some response there. Let us know what you guys think from this podcast here, from the write up itself there at 239hockey.net. I know Daily, like a scrimmage and stuff going on.
Yeah, it's starting right now. Got pushed back, so it worked out. So, all right, well, I'm going to bounce out. But, yeah, great show, guys. It was a great job. And then I will I look forward to listening to it. I usually listen to it after the fact. So, but yeah, I'm gonna go. So, all right, boys, we will catch y'all.
Thanks for joining. Everybody,
later, man. See you.